Graduating senior at Oak Grove, and I want to welcome you to worship this morning. To me, Oak Grove United Methodist Church is one big family. They have been there to support me and my family, no questions asked. When we joined in 2012, the church has provided me wonderful experiences such as confirmation and youth every Sunday night. Along the way, I have met so many new people and I have made innumerable friends. I am so proud to consider myself to be part of such an amazing community, and I cannot wait to come back and visit everyone. Please be sure to follow Oak Grove on social media to keep up with everything that is happening. In addition to Sunday morning worship, we have mission opportunities, short Bible studies, prayer time, and more. You can also find more information about being involved with Oak Grove in our Oak Grove news, which is found in the link that is posted with this worship video. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it.
Today, we celebrate the graduating class of 2020. We are so proud of our seniors, and we are excited to celebrate them on this Graduate Sunday. Congratulations, seniors. We have so enjoyed your time here at Oak Grove, and we are excited for your next chapter after high school. Now, let us enter this time of worship.
Join me in reading the Affirmation of Faith, written by the 2016 Confirmation Class that is now the graduating class of 2020. We believe God created everything, a place for everything, and everything has His life. We believe God sanctified His Son, Jesus, for our salvation. We believe the Holy Spirit is God in and around us, who guides us and protects us. We believe the Christian faith is a community in which God provides, loves, and cares for us. Jesus is active in our lives and when we serve others and when the Holy Spirit sends us out to help the world.
Domino, omnis terra, consulte Domino, conti cum nobis.
We are unsure of our feelings, we are angry and sad, when we should be joyful and excited. We are unsure of how this all fits into your plan for us. However, we know that we can come to you angry and upset as David did in Psalms. We know that you are a God who is big enough to handle our anger, our sadness, and our uncertainty. We trust that you will take these feelings and help us find a way to learn and grow. As Paul said in his letters to the Romans, suffering produces perseverance, perseverance, character, and character, hope. We are suffering, God. Our year's been snatched from us, and our celebrations have been reduced to screens. So we come to you today and ask for you to open our hearts and minds to the hope that you promise can come from this suffering. Allow us to see how these struggles can make us into the people you want us to be. Help us take this situation and see the path that will allow us to pivot to find the good, the pure, and the strong. Help us to be thankful for what we do have, family, friends, memory, and the future open to us. Let us pray the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen.
Hello, my name is William Beckner, part of Oak Grove's graduating class of 2020. I have attended Oak Grove for my whole life and have been greatly impacted by the many different activities that I've been a part of over the years. As a young child, I would attend midweek supper with my family and then go to children's choir, and I've continued that journey in choir into the youth choir. Since I joined in the sixth grade, I have gone on every youth choir mission tour and greatly enjoyed all of that. I am also part of the church's sponsored Boy Scout troop, Troop 77, where I recently achieved the rank of Eagle Scout. I have also loved being part of Oak Grove's youth group. This youth group provides a space for children to not only learn about God, but to also learn about themselves and to support others in the same journey. This is only possible through the volunteers, staff, and the giving spirit of the Oak Grove community. Please continue to make this possible for future students like me. Thank you.
Night is full of light because thy love. these words from the Gospel of John, chapter 17, verses 1 through 11. After Jesus had spoken these words, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your presence with the glory that I had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you. For the words that you gave to me, I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God."
Well, hello, graduating seniors, Mr. and Mrs. America, and all the ships at sea. We have arrived, albeit virtually, at Graduate Sunday. How do you like my costume? I wasn't sure I was going to carry on the tradition Glenn started of dressing up in costume for Graduate Sunday. Glenn is, after all, a much bigger ham than I am. You know you are, Etheridge. But as I was meeting the congregation in small groups and class meetings, I met with representatives of the youth group, and they told me about the traditions in the youth group and how important they are to you. One of the youth group members, Ramona Benefield, made a point of coming up to me after a small group meeting in her home was ending to ask me specifically if the Graduate Sunday tradition would be continuing. I said, sure, without my knowing how truly non-traditional it would be, how unlike Graduate Sundays in the past. So much of this Sunday is not at all like earlier graduation Sundays, but I knew I could make one thing be like it had always been. So behold, the senior pastor is wearing a ridiculous getup. For you, graduating seniors, only for you. So have you guessed who I'm dressed up as? If you guessed Susan Sorority from The Silent Majority, you're pretty close. Ask your grandparents about that spot-on cultural reference. She was a character Lily Tomlin played on a little show called Laugh-In. You know Lily Tomlin, the lady from Grace and Frankie. Anyway, if you guessed Cher, whom you may have seen playing the grandmother in the second Mamma Mia film, if you guessed Cher, thank you. But no, this getup, the embroidered shirt, the blue jeans, the strappy sandals, the long straight hair, the face devoid of makeup, the earrings, the schmata, this is me. High school graduate me from way back in 1977. I don't do math in my head, so have your parents get out their abacus or their slide rule and tell you how many years ago that was. But this was me. I played the cello in the orchestra. I sang in the chorus. I went on church youth choir tour. But most of the time, when I wasn't barely passing in math class, I was hanging out in, wait for it, the drama department. I was in every play, every musical, every one-act play competition ever entered by Cedar Shoals High School over in Athens. Most days after school, most weekends during the school year, several summers were spent at music or drama events. I wasn't one of the smart kids. I wasn't one of the cool kids. I was one of the artsy-fartsy kids. I even went back to my high school drama club meeting years after graduating to show them what it looked like to make a career out of dressing up in costumes and telling stories to large crowds of people. It helps if the stories are funny. And at every drama club event and play and competition, there in the crowd with me were my best friends. Kathy Kennan, who's a cousin of Miss Billy Carroll, who sings in the Oak Grove Chancel Choir, who became my best friend in sixth grade and who remains my best friend to this day. And my other best friend, Scott Lago, whom I met in ninth grade because we were seated next to each other in typing class where the seating was ranked alphabetically. So Lago sat next to LaRocca in the class. Kathy, Scott, and I were virtually inseparable. The two of them even went off to Young Harris College together after graduation while I headed off to Duke. But being apart in college did not change who we were to each other. Scott once embarked on a grueling 14-hour bus ride to come visit me in Durham. It made for one very hilarious story, which he told for years afterward. As for Kathy, I performed her wedding to her husband, Gary, and I'm the godmother to her daughter, Abigail. High school was a turbulent time for me, as I'm sure it has been for you. And there were things waiting for me in the near future that I had no idea were headed my way, as I'm sure you had no idea that a pandemic was going to shut down your senior year and do away with so many things that you had been looking forward to. There were no major political upheavals during my high school years, no wars, no nuclear holocausts, no epidemics. The wave of assassinations that claimed Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and Medgar Evers and John and Bobby Kennedy happened when I was in elementary school. I've often told the story about how my first African-American teacher in elementary school was Mrs. Woods, who pulled a television cart into our fourth grade classroom so we could watch the broadcast of Dr. King's funeral procession. It was not lost on me that 40 years later, I sat cross-legged on the floor with my kids, Ellie and Joe, and their fourth grade classmates, as the smart board in the front of the room displayed the broadcast of the inauguration of Barack Obama. I have often marveled at how things have changed from my fourth grade year to theirs. But getting back to high school, assassinations seemed to have ceased by then. There were no active wars going on either. Vietnam had ended when I was in middle school. But there was something unexpected on the horizon. The AIDS pandemic that would claim the lives of my church youth choir director, my college choir director, and six of my friends from the Cedar Shoals High School Drama Club, including Scott. This began when we were in college. The search for the drugs that would keep infected people alive took 10 years. No vaccine even now exists. But if Scott had lived just another 6 months, the protease inhibitor cocktail that succeeded in keeping most AIDS patients alive could have saved him too, and he would be alive today. Ironically, I can remember clear as day watching one Dr. Anthony Fauci speak about this virtual cure for AIDS on the television news about 6 months after Scott died. I knew I should have been happy about how many people it would save, but four words just kept running through my head over and over and over again. Too late for us. Too late for us. A week before, he was to be a groomsman in my wedding, the wedding in which Kathy was the matron of honor. Mark and I flew out to San Francisco so I could conduct Scott's funeral. It was not what we had expected. It was not what anyone had expected. It robbed us of so many things, so many happy things we had been anticipating. Life will do that. Life is doing that right now, throwing things at us that we had not expected and which we are not ready for. But while the girl with the long black hair could not possibly know what strange and sad things were coming her way, this old lady with the short gray hair has some good news to share with you, class of 2020. We may not be given the ability to know what is going to happen to us in this life, But one thing we do know, God is in the midst of everything that is happening. God is all around you in the world, and God will shield you. God will help you rise to every occasion and meet every challenge. All those things you face where your first thought is, I can't do this. I'm not smart enough. I'm not strong enough. In all of those times, remember what Jesus said in the passage we heard for this morning. In it, Jesus prays to the Father specifically for you and for me and all those of us who are alive in this world and believe in him. He prays these words to the Father for you and all of us. He said, Father, I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from this world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word, and they have believed that you sent me. I'm asking on their behalf because they are yours. Now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. Holy Father, protect them. Protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. God's protection, bestowed upon you by our Lord, will go with you wherever life takes you. God will infuse your life with direction and meaning as you find your way in the world. Even the sorrowful things that happen to you will be transformed by God into the most important work you will do in life. I didn't know in high school that the love I had for my best friend Scott would put my feet on the path to become an activist for social justice for a community I was not even really a part of. The sorrow of losing him made me love all others who were in any way like him and to feel their struggle as my own. It is not only the joyful milestones that make us who we are. When God infuses all of your life, every sadness, as well as every joy, lights up the path before you and leads you to the work God is giving you to do. Jesus said of his own life, Lord God, I glorify you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. Now that you have graduated from high school, God is preparing a way for you into the work that he has for you to do. You may not know what that work is, but God knows what it is. And God is preparing the way for you. Every experience that you have had from the day you were born until now has formed you into the person you are and has begun your transition into the person you will become. It is often said to youth in the church, oh, you're important to us because you are our future. But I am here to say to you today that this is a lie. You are not our future. You are our now. You are the church of Jesus Christ that is, and that in the future will be. Our future doesn't rest with you. Our future rests in you. If the church is to rise up to meet this new age, if we are to be a force for good in the world, if we are to change the church so that our human sin does not permeate our structures and our practices and our beliefs, it is you who will make that so. Not in some shiny future age, but now. Christ has given you this blessing, this prayer of protection from Almighty God. Great things lie ahead for each of you. Great things. Terrible things. Wonderful things. Your years of learning at home are ending. Soon you will move out into this world. And wherever you go, God will be with you. So now, class of 2020, now to work. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you. This past Saturday, our graduating seniors, their parents, and some of our amazing youth group volunteers got together to have a social distancing parade. Please enjoy this video. Go class of 2020.
It was great to watch all our graduating seniors in their parade, and it is a wonderful joy to wish them all the best that life has to offer them, and to remind them that always we are here and we are your home, and we will always be here for you. And now, as you are present with Christ in the world, love God and your neighbor in all that you do, and may God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you. Amen.